Hello students, in previous lecture we have started with chemical calculations and in chemical calculation we have discussed about the presentation of concentration for the solution. For presentation of concentration of solution we have discussed about the physical presentation or physical units or physical method. So in physical method we have discussed it is concentration of solution is presented by percentage composition. So it can be expressed by using weight by volume and volume by volume. So all three points we have discussed. Then we have discussed the presentation of concentration unit by using chemical unit. So in chemical unit it can be presented on two bases, that is weight basis and volume basis. So we have started with volume basis. And in volume basis, we have discussed about the molarity and formality, as well as we have discussed the sums based on the molarity and formality. Now today, we'll discuss about the normality. Normality of a solution is defined as number of equivalents of solute present in 1 liter of solution. So it is denoted by N, and we can say that normality is number of equivalents of solute present in 1 liter or present in V volume of solution, which is expressed in liter. So suppose if we want to say the definition of 1 molar solution, 1 normal solution, then 1 normal solution is defined as the solution which contains 1 equivalent of solute per 1 liter of solution. So that we can consider 1 normal solution. Now what is exactly mean by this number of equivalents? Number of equivalent is nothing but the amount in gram of solute per equivalent weight of solute, amount of solute in grams per equivalent weight of solute. So hence we can write normality N for the solution is amount of solute, which is expressed by W, by equivalent weight into 1 over V. So this is a formula for your normality. Now, what is exactly mean by the equivalent weight? Equivalent weight of any substance is defined as the weight of the substance which provides the Avogadro number of reacting species or Avogadro number of reacting units. Now, what is exactly mean by the Avogadro number? So, Avogadro number is 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 units. So whenever we are going to say that I have a 1 equivalent weight of any substance, so it indicates that that substance will contain 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 atoms or molecules or ions or any other similar species. Or we can say that it contains 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 entities. Now these reacting units will vary or change according to the type of reaction involved. So if you want to determine equivalent weight of any species, then it will depend on the type of reaction involved. So mainly the types of reaction involved are neutralization reaction, that is acid-base reaction, precipitation reaction, that is formation of sparingly soluble salt, complexation reaction, which involves the formation of complex, and the redox reaction, which involves oxidation and reduction reaction. Now we'll discuss one by one how the equivalent weight is determined for each type of this reaction. So very first we'll discuss for the acid-base reaction, or we can say that very first we'll discuss for the neutralization reaction. I think you are much more familiar with this neutralization reaction. Now, in this neutralization reaction, the reacting unit is hydrogen ion. So, equivalent weight of an acid or base is defined as weight of acid or base which can provide or which can react with Avogadro number of hydrogen ion, which can react or which can provide the Avogadro number of hydrogen ion. So suppose if I want to write the equivalent weight of acid, then I can write it as molar mass of acid by basicity of acid. Basicity of acid. That is equivalent weight of acid. So suppose if I take an example of HCl. Okay. And if I want to find out the equivalent weight of acid, HCl, then molar mass of HCl, whatever is there, by HCl. HCl contains one hydrogen, so basicity of acid is 1. But instead of HCl, if I take an example of H2SO4, then molecular weight of H2SO4 upon basicity of H2SO4 is 2. If I take an example of H3PO4, phosphoric acid, then molecular weight of phosphoric acid by 3, it will give me equivalent weight. So, in this way, we are able to find out equivalent weight of acid. Molar mass of acid by basicity of acid. So, for HCl, molecular weight and equivalent weight is same. For H2SO4, molecular weight is not same as equivalent weight, but equivalent weight is half of its molecular weight. While for H3PO4, that is phosphoric acid, the molecular equivalent weight is 1/3 of molecular weight. So it depends on the basicity of acid. Vice versa condition will be there for the equivalent weight of base. So, equivalent weight of base is given as molar mass of base upon acidity of base. Acidity of the base. So, suppose if I want to find out equivalent weight of NaOH, then it will be molecular weight of NaOH upon acidity of this NaOH is 1. But if I take an example of barium hydroxide, BaOH twice, then it will be molecular weight of base upon 2. Why 2? Because acidity of this base is 2. So, hope that you got my point. Now, next we are going to discuss about the precipitation and complexometric reaction. Precipitation and complexometric reaction. Now, in these reactions, the ion involved in the process are the reacting unit. So, the equivalent weight of the substance for the reaction is related to the charge carried by the ion. So, suppose in the precipitation reaction, if you want to find out Ag plus plus Cl minus, this is a precipitation reaction to give AgCl precipitate. So, in this ions involved are 1 and 1. So, equivalent weight and molecular weight is same. But suppose if you take an example of chromate, that is, K plus, twice of K plus, plus Cr2O7 or CrO4 if you take, then two it's okay. Then if you K2Cr2O7 precipitate is formed, then the ions involved are 2. So you have to divide the molecular weight by 2, and so on. Same will be there for the complexometric reaction. So this is about acid base reaction and complexometric reaction. Now next we have to discuss, that is for the redox reaction. That is for the redox reaction. Now in the redox reaction, the reacting unit is electron. Hence, equivalent weight of an oxidizing or reducing agent is defined as the weight that accepts or loses Avogadro number of electrons. I'll repeat it. Listen carefully. Equivalent weight of an oxidizing or reducing agent is defined as the weight that accepts or loses Avogadro number of electrons. Thus, the equivalent weight of an oxidizing or reducing agent is related to number of electrons that a single molecule or ion can lose or can gain. So suppose if you want to find out equivalent weight of an oxidizing agent, equivalent weight of an oxidizing agent, then it is given as molar mass upon the number of electrons accepted by a single ion or molecule. Equivalent weight of an oxidizing agent is a molar mass by number of electrons accepted by a single molecule or ion. Same way, if you want to find out equivalent weight of reducing agent, then it will be equals to molar mass upon number of electrons lost by same single ion or molecule. So that is a equivalent weight of reducing agent. So suppose if I write one chemical reaction, that is a redox reaction. So I'll write this Fe plus 3, twice of Fe plus 3 plus Sn plus 2 will gives you Sn plus 4 plus twice of Fe plus 2. So this is a redox reaction. If I split up reaction and if I write down oxidation and reduction reaction, then I can write it as twice of Fe plus 3 plus 2 electrons will gives you twice of Fe plus 2, and Sn plus 2 will gives you Sn plus 4 plus 2 electrons. So 2 electrons will get cancelled and you will get this. You can say that the number of, you can say that, or net cell, net reaction, net redox reaction. So if you want to find out equivalent weight of iron Fe plus 3, then it will be molar mass upon 1, because number of electrons involved, suppose 2, 2, 2 will get cancelled, number of electrons involved in 1. If you want to find out equivalent weight of Sn plus 2, then it will be molar mass upon 2. Molar mass upon 2. So in redox reaction, you are able to find out the equivalent weight by considering number of electrons accepted or lost by the species. But in redox reaction, equivalent weight of oxidizing or reducing agent will vary depending upon the redox reaction and other reactant involved in it, and even it will depend on the medium in which the reaction is carried out. So for this, I would like to share one example. Suppose if we consider the example of MnO4-1. If I am going to carry out the reaction in acidic medium, then my final product is Mn+2. The electrons gain are 5. Okay, or just I'll write the electrons involved in the reaction are 5. So equivalent weight will be equals to molecular weight upon 5 or molar mass upon 5. Same way, suppose if I am going to carry out the same one in neutral media, then final product is MnO4. The electrons involved are 3. So next, I have to divide the molar mass by 3. And same way, if I carry out the reaction in basic media or in alkaline media, then the final product will be MnO4-2. The electrons involved are 1. So molar mass divided by 1. So in 3 different cases, acidic media, neutral media, basic media, the equivalent weight for the same species is different. It is 5 divided by 5, divided by 3, divided by 1 to the molar mass. Okay. Now we'll discuss about the advantage of normality, or how the normality is useful for us, or whether the if we are going to deal with the normality, whether it is useful for us or not. Okay. So dealing with normality is main advantage of normality is that whenever you are going to use this, at that time, two species will always have the stoichiometry 1:1. So stoichiometry is 1:1. Stoichiometric ratio is 1:1. So which is not possible in molarity, which is not possible in formality. So stoichiometric ratio is 1:1. Hence we are able to use the formula N1V1 equals to N2V2. Okay. And it's very easy, and we are able to use it for the calculations. But again, there is a disadvantage of the normality, and it is that it depends on the reaction. Okay, normality depends on the reaction, that is whether it is acid-base reaction, whether it is precipitation reaction, whether it is complexometric or whether it is redox reaction. So normality always depends on the reaction, and it can change from one reaction to another reaction for the same species. So just now we have discussed the example. Even it depends on the medium in which you are going to carry out the reaction. So for that also we have seen, or we have discussed the example. As well as for the same substance, two different reactions are possible. Hence, for the same substance, there may be two equivalent weights. So, for this, I will share one example. Na2CO3, sodium carbonate plus HCl will give you NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate plus NaCl. Same with by using the same reactant, that is Na2CO3 plus twice HCl will give you twice NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. So in these two species, the number of H plus ion included are different. So in this both cases, the for the same substance, that is for the same sodium carbonate, equivalent weight will be different. So this is considered as a disadvantage of the normality, but otherwise normality calculation, doing calculation by using normality is very good, because stoichiometric ratio is maintained always 1:1. Now we'll discuss the sum based on this normality. So very first I'll read the sum. 3.6 gram of oxalic acid, molecular formula is H2C2O4 twice H2O, is dissolved and the volume is made up to 150 ml. Calculate the normality of the solution for acid-base titration and normality of the solution for redox titration. So very first, they have given molecular weight of oxalic acid. So now very first, we'll calculate the normality for the acid-base titration. Now as the H molecular formula is H2C2O4, twice H2O. So number of hydrogen ion involved in the reaction are 2. So very first, we'll find out equivalent weight. Equivalent weight equals to molecular weight upon basicity of acid. Over here basicity of acid is 2, hence equal molecular weight is 126 upon 2, so equivalent weight will be equals to 63. Now as we know, the formula for normality is N equals to W, molecular weight, upon E, equivalent weight, into 1 over V. So in this case W is equals to 3.6, it's given 3.6 gram of oxalic acid upon equivalent weight is 63 multiplied by 1 over V, V is 150 ml, that is equals to 0.15 liter. So 0.15. So if you find out answer for this, it is equals to 0.381 normal. Now next they have told you find out normality of a solution for redox reaction. So for that, very first we'll write the reaction. So H2C2O4, it will gives you twice CO2 plus twice H plus plus 2 electrons plus 2 electrons. So in this case the electrons involved are 2. So find out first equivalent weight. Equivalent weight will be equals to molar mass upon number of electrons gain or lost by the molecule. So here number of electrons are 2. So divided by 2. So 126 upon 2 is equals to 63. And then remaining part is same. Normality is equals to weight in grams upon equivalent weight upon 1 over V. So weight in grams is 3.6 upon equivalent weight is 63 into volume is 0.15. Your answer will be same, 0.381 normal. So it is same in this case, but may be different for different cases. So just keep in mind always this difference. So that's all for your normality. In next lecture we'll discuss with the next part. Thank you.